Tariq Nazal says he missed his little sister Loreen the most. Israeli authorities held the 15-year-old under arrest for 3 months last year, charging him with throwing stones at Israeli soldiers. He says he was questioned without a legal counsel or member of his family being present, and he only saw his mother once, from a distance while he was detained.
My friend was arrested with me. The Israeli interrogator told him that I confessed against him, that he threw stones. They wanted him to confess against me as well. He came back to the prison room angry and shouting, thinking that I did that to him. He almost hit me there.
Palestinian prisoners' associations say that teenagers like Tariq and even younger children are often arrested late at night or during confrontations with the Israeli army in the occupied West Bank. They are tried in military courts, and around half face charges of hurling stones that carry a prison sentence of around 6 months. Now, the Israeli human rights organization HaMoked is petitioning the courts to allow minors to have access to phones.
The phone contact with the families is doubly important. I mean, of course, it's a basic right, but also when you look at everything these kids are going through, it's very important for them to have some sort of support from their families.
Luay Mansi tried to fill that void. He spent years in jail until his release a few weeks ago and looked after young detainees while he was there. He says some inmates were as young as 12 and found him the only consolation.
Some of them start crying. They tell me, I want my parents, I want my mum, but I know there's little I can do, so I'm forced to lie to them. I say, you'll be able to talk to your mum soon, and she'll visit in 10 days, just so they can calm down and start adapting.
It usually takes more than 2 months for parents to get a visitor's permit, but sometimes they never do. They're allowed to attend their children's military trial, but they're asked not to touch or talk to each other.
In the Gaza Strip, many Palestinians say the situation is usually worse. Rafat Daour says his 16-year-old son, Youssef, was arrested 3 months ago. He's accused of trying to smuggle himself into Israel. Rafat says he doesn't know much about what's happened to his son since his arrest and is worried he won't be able to visit him.
I was arrested in the past, so I might be banned from visiting him as they would deem me a security threat.
The Israeli army says the juvenile military court is designed to improve the rights of minors. But according to those representing them, many young inmates suffer physical and psychological harm in jail, and having no contact with their families makes that worse. Nida Ibrahim, Al Jazeera, the Occupied West Bank.